Welcome back, everybody. We're going to be continuing our playthrough of Soul of the Samurai. Tojo Castle, evil presence in the dark, fills the air and night. Okay, so we picked up the golden glasses yesterday, and I'm gonna show you why. First, let's equip a new weapon. Fire damage, as well as speed. Oops, wrong path. Oh, gotta fight them. Those gold-eyed glasses. Miss, I would be very grateful if you could return them to me.
Why, yes, certainly.
Thank you so kindly, I can't thank you enough. Ah, I know what I can do to show my thanks. If we have any clothing that suits you, it's yours. Yeah, and now we can change our costume. Let's go with this. Ah, it suits you wonderfully. You'll just slay the men. If you ever get tired of that outfit, please come exchange it. Right. Oopsie daisy. God damn. Yeah, things are like, thing just went from 0 to 100 real fast. Now we got like weird ass demons roaming the street and stuff. Dude. Oh my goodness. Like, I don't understand when can I attack and when can I not. Oh my fucking shit. That didn't even do anything! Oh my goodness. Waste of fucking time. Problem is, I can't even like skip him or just ignore him or something. I gotta fight him, dude. Oh my goodness, Fucking shit! Even the final boss doesn't have iframes like this. And there should be a save point. Oh my goodness. God damn. Okay, honestly, I'm not very confident about this. Yeah. That's what I thought. Piece of shit. Let's try again. All right. The reason I'm going here is because I want to try to see if I can farm for some items, possibly. No. Nope, nothing. Although I am curious, I don't think I've ever entered this area as Lynn before. Oh shit. God damn it. Oh my goodness. This duo again. Dude, the explosion gives off the impression that a nuke went off. But hey, better to take advantage of the utility. Should have done that last time. Alright. Let's just save before we go further. Meaning no hatred. Kill the sword to make bloom the Petrinia. Okay. Not sure what that means, but okay. Hippity hoppity. Oh, so that's what the smoke does. Oopsie daisy. Oop. That artwork though, dude, that the pre-rendered backgrounds, they look, I don't know about you guys, but they look nice to me. Like, seriously. Gotta watch out for those guys. Oopsie daisy. There we go. When you know that there's a safe point on the main story path, you know some shit's going down. Meaning no hatred. I've been waiting for you, Shogunate dog. Your time is up, Gendo Tojo. Quit your whelping. Quiet your yelping, you wretched spy. Spying has nothing to do with this. I'm here to avenge my brother. Brother? Ah, his strong will made him impossible to control. But nonetheless, he was a most useful tool. Stop it. I won't stand for any more indignity upon my brother. Don't you wish for more power, the power that sleeps within you? I want it. I want it all. Soon. Soon it'll all be mine. You're getting nothing if I can help it. With your blood, I will celebrate the coming fruition of my dream. Fruitian? I'm not sure. I don't think I've seen that word before. Alright. Oh shit. I did it, Kotaro. This whole nightmare is over. A little too easily, maybe. Yeah, it's not over. In order to get the final true ending, we need to play as Kotairo as well. So we just need to wait a bit, because I can't skip the credits. '99, oh my goodness. 21 years. To the Red Sea of blood sinks and vanishes. Ronin Kotairo Hiba. Chapter 1, Homecoming. Kotaro Hiba, a masterless samurai in training, makes his return to visit his parents' graves. Upon arrival, he is caught up in a deadly incident with a young girl and the law. The Ronin makes his way to a Bushido dojo to meet Yokinosuke, a childhood friend. The thing is, the problem is, like, his slashes are very slow with the first swords, but then once you get a hold of the better swords, like, it just makes your life easier. Yokinosuke, look who's back. What? You killed some lawmen? I don't care who they were. They were in the wrong, but something about their eyes were odd. I must have imagined it. Well, I see you haven't changed your ways much. This old dojo hasn't changed much either. Do you remember how you and I trained together? How could I forget those days? I'm bored of just practicing. Come on, Yokonezuke, I'll take you on. We can't go, Taro. Master will be angry with us. Nobody's watching. Come on, that'll be alright. Oh, okay. Just this once, though. No need for this. So let's just skip it. You two, stop. You pups are far from ready. Hey, Yokonezuke, are you listening? What? What do you mean, what? I said I'm going to the graveyard to pay my respects. The graveyard? Do you mean to go to the temple? What are you flustered about? Something wrong at the temple? No, you just came back. What's your hurry? It's one of those things you do first. Duty calls. But I won't be long. Have the sake out. We need to catch up. Kotaro Hiba, when did you return? Ryu Oda, the military scholar. Still the same, I see. Have you finally decided to serve Lord Tojo? Not on your life. Why are you men acting so aggressively? I hope you're not firing them up for another war. The age of the sword has ended. My parents died in the war, and they would have enjoyed hearing that. Lord Toja has summoned for you. Please get ready for now. Yes, right away. By the way, Yukonosuke, how have things gone since? I get the odd headache, but otherwise I'm fine. I knew you would not disappoint. Lord Tojo shall be pleased. Endure a little longer and be rewarded with fantastic power. Kotaro Hiba has come back. Yes, he left to visit the graveyard. The temple. That is amusing. Kotaro? Ouch. There's something wrong with these castle lawmen. They feel wrong even through the sword. This is creepy. Ew. There is no escape. Die. Who goes there? This just isn't my day. Are you all right? Thank you. My sword shall taste your blood too. Hold on. No, I'm doomed. Please, I need you to. What's this? Give it to my colleagues. Colleagues? This fiefdom bugs. Store code letter. Love hours inside my heart bounding up and down from pure nostalgia. Yeah. Chapter 2, Mystery. On the way to the temple, Kotaro is beset by murderous samurai. After defeating the grotesque and sinister enemies, Kotaro comes to the aid of a mysterious monk. But too late, the monk dies before Kotaro's eyes, leaving only the words, bugs. Hi, honey, remember me? I'm Kotaro Hiba. We seem to run into each other. I'm Lin. I suppose we're both lucky to be alive. Could this girl be a colleague of that monk's? I'm sorry, but I have no time for idle chats. I'm going. Wait, before you go, honey, do you know anything about this? Who did you get this from? Is he still alive? No, he's dead. What does that say? I can't read it at all. What do you want to know? You shouldn't get involved in this. Can't ignore this. If I had a kid sister, she'd be like you. You have no right to say that. But I still owe you. Thanks for this. Thank you, farewell. So much for my lack of interest in kids. Anyway, the graveyard duty calls. Is this the right path? I'm not sure. Oh no, it isn't. At least I don't think it is it? Okay, this leads to the castle. Oh yeah, I think this is the path. Oh shit. Excuse me, are you going into the temple? Yeah, I'm going to the graveyard. May I tag along? There's something wrong inside the temple. There's something wrong? Well, whatever. Sure, come on. Pretty late is always welcome. Really? Thank you. I'm here to visit my mother's grave. Cape jasmine flowers remind me of my dear mother, long clouds in the sky. Halt, no one passes here. Get lost. Castle lackeys are here too? What are you doing here? I don't have to answer that if you refuse to leave. Wait. Then you can join the corpses. Die. Hey, are you alright? What is going on? Why did they attack us? The lawmen around here are all acting insane. Lady, I think it's time you headed home. This is the anniversary of my mother's death. Now I'm convinced that this just isn't my day. Lady, stick close to me. A mound of bodies. What are they doing here? This is awful. All right. Oops, oh my goodness. Almost slashed her. We must be safe here. Can I have the keys? I'll go ahead. Lady, I said stick with me. Why don't I tell you? Help me! That way. All right. You're the priest? No, this is a surprise. You came back, Otero. What happened to you? What are you doing with the girl? She'll make a fine gift for Lord Tojo. Tojo? What does he have to do with this? It'll be a waste of breath to tell you, for you shall die. What? I've been praying to test my new powers. I'm the priest. There's a graveyard. There's a perfect place to die. I don't know what you are, but you're the one going to the grave. Damn, what happened here? No, oh no. And the graves have been dug up, my father would be devastated. Somebody's gonna pay for this. But why? What are they going to do with the, what are they gonna do with the corpses? Look over there. Is that a cave? Look at all the footprints. Those men must have been in there. Maybe they carried the bodies in there. Looks that way. I want to get to the bottom of this. Don't go in there. I have a horrible feeling about this. Don't worry about me, but you should go on home. I will, but listen. I live at the edge of town at a blacksmith shop named Benny. If you need work done on your sword, come see us anytime. I'll speak to my father about you. Alright, good. That's a promise to keep. Osafune. Dude's dropped to the ground. There must be 15 minutes there. Or a nest of snakes. Chapter 3. So bugs. The temple priest Muga had been transformed into a bizarre monster. To solve the mystery of the priest's mutation and the mound of newly disinterred corpses, Kotaro alone ventures into an underground cave where unknown horrors await. Ta-da-da-da. The rope snapped. There's no going back. Better look for another way out. What is this? Holy shit. Almost fell there, bud. Alrighty. Hmm? What's that sound? And let's save, because there is honestly a very annoying boss fight. The moon hides her face, digging salt for potatoes. Tell me this season. Check that out. What? Oh. So this is where they were bringing the corpses. Do these things have something to do with the human monsters? How dare you trot upon my beloved soul bugs? Who's that? Soul bugs? Is this some kind of trickery? What are you, a sorcerer? So you're behind all this. You're paying with your life. I am but a mere servant. I am a master to only bugs. What are you playing out here with your bugs? Soul bugs are born here and enter their hosts. This is their nest. I hear that they are having smashing fun in the human hosts outside. Soul bugs are parasites that turn people into monsters. Ah, enlightenment. Lord Tojo's plans cannot be stopped now. Tojo's plans? I may or slip up my tongue, no matter. You shall soon be a particular fine host to my bugs. Oh shit. Piece of shit! Controls are already as awkward as they is. You gotta be floating around like that? Oh my goodness. Fucking pixel of a health. The cave is coming down. Gotta get out. My soul bugs. You have served us well, Urabi. That voice, Oda, what is the meaning of this? You have outlived your usefulness. That cannot be. This plan cannot succeed without me. You failed to dispose of that lone Ronin. What use are you? Who do you think made the plan possible? And it was you, Oda, who promised to keep intruders out. You can save your excuses for the afterlife. Let me talk to Lord Tojo. He still needs my bugs. We have a new colony thanks to my research. You can rot here with your beloved bugs. Wait. No. I shall not die here alone. Gotaro Hiba, you are coming with me. My beautiful soul bugs, give me your strength. Where's the exit? Sort of forgot a bit. Whoa, I'll be smashed flat if I don't hurry. Let's make sure. Dude, I'm sorry, this map makes no sense, but I think this is where I'm supposed to go. Alright, there we go. Ha, a way out. You persistent freak. Oh shit. Giant candidate finding no other place to die keeps on walking around. Chapter 4, The Nest. In the horrific cavern, Kotaro discovers a subterranean lake. The lake teems with soul bugs, profane creatures that turn mortals into monsters. Kotaro barely escapes the collapsing cave with the knowledge that the Fighters' ruler is somehow involved. The village square. Never expected to end up here. Wow, monsters, help! Damn, they've even invaded the village. I may have left once, but I won't allow this to happen here. Fire sword. Let's see if I can reach through 100. I doubt it, but let's try. Thank you.
Almost there. Yes, we reached 300. Oh, man, finally, that's like the whole population of the village. I guess that was the last of them. Oh, damn, Yoka Nasuke. They better not have gone to the dojo. Gotaro Hiba, I presume. Who are you? I shall await you at Ganru Beach. Come for the sake of honor. God, what presence. He held me rooted. He reeks of death. Ganru Beach. Should I go? Yes, we're gonna go to Ganru Beach before heading to Yukonosuke because we can earn dual swords. You're not laying one finger on my shop. No. Hey, listen. Ah, please take anything, but don't kill me. Oh, thank you. I owe you my life. If there's anything I can do, just say it. I'm the Master Tailor Ito at your service. Ah, my savior, thank you for coming. If there's anything I may do for you, just say it. But what can you do for me? I know, this is what I'll do. If we have any clothing that suits you, it's yours. Come, get out of those horribly scruffy clothes. We'll go with this. See, you look like an entirely new man. If you ever get tired of that outfit, come, change it here anytime. Thank you.
Oh damn, that's a lot of damage. Two, three. Get up. One, two, three. Oh, yo, yo, yo. And here's a blacksmith. Hello, is your daughter in? Ah, you must be Kotaro Hiba. My daughter owes her life to you. Unfortunately, she's gone out. That's too bad. Gone out at a time like this? Okay. As you can see, I run the blacksmith shop. Please, may I see your sword? Oh my. Though it is rusted, this is truly a most remarkable sword. Please leave it with me for a restoration. Sure, that's fine. Being such a fine instrument, it would take some time. Please return for it. This will be a most challenging job. Not sure which sword he's talking about, to be honest. But I guess I'll finish my business with that samurai on the beach, and then I'll return. Hopefully he'll be done with the sword by the time I get back. The hem of garments turned vermilion in autumn, hoping it never ends. Oh shit, 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 shit. Nice, abundance of vile healing items, that's what I like. So, you have come. You have a name? I am Musashi. What do you want of me? I wish to challenge you to a duel. Honor and death are at stake. So, you were hired by Tojo? No, that's not true. Like you, I serve no master. I am a Ronin. Then listen, there's something happening in this fiefdom. I know all about it, but it is of no concern to my swords. You dare not turn away from me now. Come, defend your honor. This music is really relaxing. That was magnificent. Were you infected by those soul bugs too? Does it matter? To live for the sword is the samurai way. To lose my life to a samurai like you, I'm blessed. To live and to die by the sword, that was all I desired. I want you to take my swords, will you? Yes, I will. Thank you. And now, we have dual swords. And I can't go because I gotta take him down. Alright, dude, get closer. Alright, let's check out if the sword is ready. I guess he's not done yet. I better come back later. What? When? Okay, maybe after... Maybe after I'm done checking on Yokonosuke. Hang on, Yokonosuke. I'm on my way. Chapter 5. Friend. Kotaro emerges to find his home village overrun by monsters. Enraged, he mows them down in the knowledge that they are villagers who have been infected by the soul bugs. He hurries to Yokonosuke's dojo to protect his childhood friend from the ghastly carnage. Alright guys, we're gonna stop here, and we'll see you guys in the next part. Thank you so much for watching the video. Peace.